عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. إمام بخاري رحمه الله تعالى narrated a beautiful hadith in his Sahih that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن الله تبارك وتعالى إذا أحب عبدا نادى جبريل. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves one of his servants. Now, look what will happen here, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do with this love. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah loves one of his servants, what will do? Nada Jibreel. Allah will call Jibreel. And we know Jibreel is the leader of the angels. Jibreel is Sayyidul Malaika. Nada Jibreel. Allah will call Jibreel. إن الله then Allah will say يا جبريل أو جبريل إن الله قد أحب فلانا فأحبه. أو جبريل Allah has loved so and so, and Allah will mention the name of this person, so make sure you love him. فيحبه جبريل, then جبريل will love him. Then Allah said ثم ينادي جبريل, then جبريل will call في السماء, all people of the heavens. He will make big announcements. How many angels in the heaven? Allah knows. Millions, billions of angels. Jibreel will call upon all of them. He have an important announcement from the Lord of the whole universe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is this announcement? This message and this announcement is Nada Jibreel fi sama, Inna Allah qad ahabba fulanan fa'ahibbu. O people of the heaven, Allah has loved so and so, will mention the name of this person. So everybody love this person, then the whole people on the creations of the heavens will love this person. Wow. That's not all. There is more. Then will call upon the people of the earth as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the qabool for that person in the hearts of all his creation on earth. Who would do something like that except the one who loves? And that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah loves one of his servants, doesn't keep it secret. Allah shows his love and announcements. Then Allah will call the closest angel to him, which is Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah will tell Jibreel, I love my servant so and so. Love him for me. Jibreel will love him. Right away, the love of Allah will enter the heart of Jibreel and will love that servant of Allah. Then Jibreel will go and will call among the people of the heaven and will make this big announcement. What is this announcement? It's announcements of love. It's announcements of Allah's love. Yes, Allah's love is not something little. Who is this lucky servant who got Allah's love? Then all the people of the heaven will hear his name. He will be well known. Not only that, his love will enter the heart of everything Allah created in the heaven. Allah, Allah, how beautiful the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then as well with the people of the earth, and Allah will put the qabool, spread, that all people on earth will accept that person. And they love that person. And they feel connected to that person. Where that came from? From the love of Allah. This is the divine love. This is the true love. When you say love, this is the love. This is the only love that deserve to sacrifice for. This is the only love that deserve to give everything for it. To do everything possible to get Allah's love subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, فَقُلْ رَبُّكُمْ ذُو رَحْمَةٍ وَاسِعَةٍ. Say, your Lord is the Lord of infinite mercy. Your Lord is the Lord of infinite mercy. Look how he described his rahmah. فَقُلْ رَبُّكُمْ. So he said, say, your Lord. He didn't say the Lord of the heavens and the earth. He didn't say the God. He used the word Rabb. And not only that, and he add the letter Kaf and Mim after it, So this is Al-Mulkiyya, says Rabbukum, your Lord. So this Lord belongs to you and you belong to him. So he is your Lord. So that's called Rabbukum for you as a servant of Allah. When you hear it in the Quran, right away it gives you the feeling of aman, security, and peace and comfort, because this is my Lord. Then he talked about his rahmah, what he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ذو رحمة واسعة, the Lord of infinite mercy. He described his mercy as an infinite mercy. What is mercy? Mercy is a fruit of the love. When there is love, there is mercy. If there is no love, no mercy. So the mercy is a fruit of Allah's love. If the mercy of Allah is infinite, you can imagine now the love of Allah. How great is it? Allah. This is Allah's love. For us as believers, we must feel the love of Allah. We must hear the calls of the love of Allah in the Quran. Quran is rich, talking about the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's like a garden of love. You walk in it, you will see the love of Allah everywhere. You just get to feel it and to enjoy it. You must breathe and smell the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the mercy of Allah. And in the other ayah, Allah said, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. Allah. Because he loves his servants. So that's why he كَتَبَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. So the rahmah of Allah is going to be there, and that's guarantee from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one ever can come and change this thing about Allah. He is Rahman. Nobody can change that. He is Rahim. Nobody can change that as all. And these names, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, it gives you the aman. It gives you the security. This is the rahmah of Allah. Then he said in the other ayah, وَرَبٌّ غَفُورٌ. Allah, that's a Lord who is all forgiven. Ya Salam. What should we do? What can we say? How can we thank you, Allah, for all this love? You describe yourself as Rahman and Rahim. And you describe yourself as Ghafoor. Allah, what else do we need? What else do we need? If this is our Lord, how can we turn our hearts away from him? How? How would we turn our hearts away from someone who is all merciful? Someone who is Rahman, someone who is Rahim, someone who is Ghafoor, someone who is Sabur, someone who is Shakur. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can't turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to keep our hearts all the time connected with him, feeling his love, living his love, the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another beautiful ayah that shows the divine of love, the divine love, it shows the love of Allah. It says, وَمَنْ يَقْتَرِفْ حَسَنَةً نَزِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Whoever earn and do a good hasana for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نَزِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنًا. We will increase it for him. We'll make it more beautiful, because hasana is from husn, which means a beauty, something beautiful, something good. Now Allah will make it more beautiful. What is the things that makes our good better? The qabool of Allah. When Allah accepts it, then that good is not good anymore. It becomes better. So Allah will add his qabool on it. Then it will become better. نَزِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنًا. The reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Indeed Allah is all forgiving. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is grateful, which means Allah appreciates what you do. And before he appreciates, he acknowledges and he is aware of what you do for him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the beautiful connection between us and our beloved Lord Allah the Almighty. My dear brothers and sisters, who would speak like that except the one who loves? These are the calls of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I said, Quran is rich of these examples. But we need to open our hearts and soften it and try to be able to hear the calls of Allah and feel his love and try to live his love. Allahumma ameen. May Allah make this easy for all of us. Open our heart, fill it up with his love and his rahmah, and brings us closer to him in this dunya and the akhirah. Allahumma ameen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.